here, first question, like as a guest lecturer at Shazia IIT Kharagpur, what do you think are the things a student studying at IIT Kharagpur would be inspired by? By this sort of events, by the guest lecturers we have?
I think I saw a huge interest in matters of governance, in matters of civic engagement, in the conversations that we had about people and their MLAs, MPs, the relationship between the government and the people. So I think more of these opportunities should be there, so people know how to relate their curriculum and their work to governance, to the service of people.
So do you think that in IIT Kharagpur there should be some courses of public administration?
Yes, I definitely think courses of public administration, better governance, they should definitely be a part of the curriculum. Or be offered as a
minor course or as a politician, social activist and journalist, in which direction do you think the people in general and the youth of India in particular should think?
They are not sure it's very many. People are most at whichever way they want. But what I'm seeing increasingly about the youth is that they're not taking things like that. They're demanding a better future. They are less accepting of the reality, like maybe we were, or the generation before me. They ask for thoughts, and they're in a hurry. And they are more democratic in nature. They are not taken in by these caste, class divides. Maybe it's technology, maybe it's a new age, but they want to be on issues. And so they question the parents, they question the grandparents, they question old systems, they question status quo, they want to know why. So they're ready to give up the baggage that the parents are carrying and start fresh. Which is a great sign, because it can go either way. But I think if it's channelized, they can really work towards creating better systems.
Ma'am, so you have been frequently described as a media strategist, who's a journalism experience. So now it's quite naturally obvious that youngsters tend to be more tech savvy. Yes. Do you know, are you suggesting that you should, in that sense, like they should connecting politics with, Arvind Kejriwal has been frequently cited as the politician who's been bringing up social networking into politics. So, what would you recommend for youngsters, to get into politics through social media?
No, all that is fine. Technology keeps changing. And I'm not saying it to discourage you. But what you're saying is as important as how you're saying it. How you're saying it, earlier there were letters, then there were emails, now there are SMSs, MMSs. That is the form. So technology, the form of technology can change. Listen to the answer. The form of technology can change. The content, the substance, the political message you want to give, that should be important. You can have the best social media sites, but your message, if it's not good enough, if it doesn't connect with you, it'll be useless.
Ma'am, but the platform that social media offers, I mean, it cannot be competed by any other platform.
Sure.
So, in that sense, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal has been quite successful because, I have liked his page and, I get frequent updates and he personalizes it so much. Based on that, do you think Aam Party should focus more on that to attract more youngsters?
I think all kinds of media, social media definitely, because so much goes on there and because the ease with which you can communicate, you don't have to depend on big media houses. Like I mentioned, so many big media houses can be biased against you. It can be pro-establishment. But on social media, you can spread the word virtually without any money at great speed. It's instantaneous. So whether it's a protest somewhere, whether it's communication of a new idea, it can spread, and once it goes viral, even the traditional media is forced to cover it. That is the power of social media.
Ma'am, I saw a campaign video of your contesting for the article on
Kashmir.
So, there you mentioned that, you were asked by one of the journalists that you could have, contested from a constituency that would have been, had a high Muslim population or something like that, and you said that you preferred to contest from Athipuram because of the Delhi gang rape, you know, yes, to bring more and more influence of women into politics.
I did not even think, you know, normally how does anybody who wants to contest an election, what do they think of? They think of deliberate. They say, oh, I'm a judge, I'm a judge, I'm a judge. Even parties when they want to decide on a candidate, they say, oh, yeah, Brahman votes aata hai, ya Dalit votes aata hai, ya Muslim votes aata hai. Uske hisab se they choose. I didn't see any of that, I was mad. In these times.
Despite that, you lost by a very small
very tough seat, and you know.
Yes.
And there were hardly any Muslims there, which I got to know later. Because I don't see myself like that, you see. I see myself as a citizen of this country. I see myself as somebody who must talk about women's issues and women's security. It's a very big issue. The Nirbhaya gang rape happened in Malinka, which is Athipuram constituency. And I said, we talk about Jat vote bank, Brahmin vote bank, Dalit vote bank. What about women? Who talks about them? So let me start. I don't care if I win or lose, but we want to showcase this. This was my point of view. Why not, you know?
What issues in particular do you want to bring up, you know, as in terms of feminism?
But I feel this is for women and men. You know, sometimes even women want to derive an extra, a different identity based on. But I feel in public spaces we are equals. We are all equals. So I think it's important to know that instead of either getting a subservient position or a position of entitlement, know that we are public. You know, some women feel, oh, because we're women, we must get it. It's a sense of entitlement. You know, like that also is as much a gender bias than being not taken seriously because they're women. So either way, women should be equals. See, in terms of identity, you could be a mother at home, a daughter at home, or whatever. But at work, you're a colleague, you're a professional, you're a fellow student. So that's what I say. So be equals, and that's how I see it.
There
are different identities for different times. You know what I mean? Yeah. So
I think that was your rationale.
Not only is he playing a woman. When you're queuing up at an immigration, you're an Indian citizen. When you come back home, you become a daughter. You know, say namaste, mummy, at home, you know, whatever. So, when you play with your nephews and nieces, you're the masi. It changes, you know, your identity keeps changing. When you meet your old friend, you're a pal. When you meet your boyfriend, you're a cute girlfriend. No, I'm just telling you, this is how it is. So, and when you go out and work, you're an anchor, you're an anchor. You're an engineer, you're an engineer. You're a doctor, you're a doctor. Just like that. And when aliens will come to attack you, then you'll be a human. You know, so taking it further. So identities keep changing. All the time being, I'm a woman, I'm a Muslim, I'm a Dalit, I'm a Jat. You wear this on a sleeve too much, you know. There's a role for identity different times. Not all the time.
You come from
a question, I feel very strongly about it.
You come from a reputed and well-known family,
yes,
which has been active in politics since long time. Does it influence your career? You have any emotion in your mind like earlier when you were an anchor?
Yes. See, when you're a political journalist yourself, and I come from a place from Kanpur, in a very ghettoized area, where in a Muslim area, where women are treated a certain way. So you come from a position, a place of injustice. And you always want to, in your own house, you have to fight biases against your brothers. Then even you go out, you see larger biases. So you're motivated by something called a desire for justice, for equity. And I think it's the need to fight something wrong that keeps me going. So that definitely has influenced me.
In that context, what about the recent incident about the student from Arunachal Pradesh in Delhi?
It's
very sad. Just recently, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal posted a photo with students from Arunachal Pradesh saying, you know, that he'll make sure that justice.
It's very unfair, and we condemn it strongly. I have so many friends. My roommate was from Nagaland, so I know all the stories. We made a film together on the same subject. And they are constantly harassed. Again, identity.
Yeah, that's not in that context.
We keep looking at each other through these very superficial identities. Northeast, Muslim, Hindu. We keep doing it. You know, it's so silly. You have to go beyond. You have to. We're fixed in identities. That's the same question.
As a journalist, what were your experiences which if known, would suddenly influence the students here at IIT Kharagpur?
So many. For instance, there was a girl, she was Miss Jammu, and there was a story on her. They made some kind of a film on her, and the film was being shown everywhere, and they were harassing her. And when I was a journalist, I saw Ashtak, I was in Star News. They were playing the girl. Of course, they blurred parts of it, and the girl, so I decided, I said, I'm an anchor, I can change this. So I said, instead of talking about the girl who apparently was drugged and the film was made, of course the girl was saying I'm not there and the film was being distributed. I said, who are the men who made the film? Who are the men who watched the film? Who are the men who distributed the film? Which are the channels and what action? Instead of taking action against the girl, I changed the whole story and I said, it's as wrong to distribute a film or even watch something like that. So you change the discourse by asking a different question. So instead of making the girl the focus, I made men the focus. And I said, why is there any action being taken against them? And why against a poor girl? So, you know, and the girl actually called me later in the night. She said, you're the only journalist who was bothered about me. So there are many such cases and you just take a stand.
Students at IITs tend to migrate to developed nations, like mostly US after graduation. What changes do you think would lessen this situation that they have?
The desire to contribute. I think the deep desire to contribute to India's growth, the desire to serve the country, the desire to give some of your time for betterment of the nation. And anything, it could be any sector, whether it's health or education or infrastructure, a lot can be done. And I think, I'm not saying don't go abroad, I will not be one of those people who say, oh my god, it's criminal to be selfish. No, I'm not saying that. But I'm saying give a part of your life to this nation. And because, and if we won't do it, who will? So I think it's absolutely a must. And you know something? You realize when you give how great it is. It's true happiness. People have been all over the world and then they come back because they feel they have everything. But they want to do something more, which might not be easy, but it gives them deep satisfaction.
Ma'am, I mean, that coming as a national executive of the party in the coming Lok Sabha elections, do you have any strategies that you could share with us?
Arvind has already announced a strategy. We've taken up 25 names so far. I think 23 or 28 names
something
here. Yeah, we've got a list of names.
Ma'am, you initially said you would contest 350 seats.
Yes, but then we thought about it. We're getting so stuck with 300, 400. What do we want to communicate? We don't want to fight elections for elections' sake. We just want a parliament which does not have criminals. We want a parliament where 2-3 members of the same family are not there. We want everyone else, all of you, your parents, people you know to get a chance. So just, we'll fight 300. 400 for what? We're not fighting election because we have to fight an election. We're not fighting election because we want to see a better parliament, a better executive, not a compromised set of people, you know, who play really nearly to the crony capitalists. We want people to make a difference. That's the whole idea. This is why we changed the strategy. It was largely Arvind's idea. But let's start off with this. And let's get the names from the people. And then more and more and more and more. You know, so that's the idea.
What are your views about women's reservation?
See, women's reservation, first of all, women are represented. But for me, I'm going to make a difference. For me, like, handsome is what handsome does. So now Rabi Devi is a woman, but you know she was there because of Lalu. Do we want that? Supriya Sule is there because of Sharad Pawar. Pratinidhi Shinde is there because of Sushil Shinde. Agatha Sangma is there because of P.A. Sangma. This one, Mulayam Singh Yadav, Bahu Dimple Yadav contested only because Akhilesh Yadav and Mulayam Singh Yadav are there. So we want real women to be there, you know. Mamata is, she didn't have any backing, godfather or husband. So this love of wives, daughters-in-law, daughters, widows. It's not parivar vaad. I have a problem. Let women be there from the last months. They should be there. Very clear views.
Ma'am, a question.
Most of them, they don't have voter ID cards. And it's not, they are very much active in Facebook, they support Aam Aadmi Party there.
Why don't they have voter ID cards?
Because it's not possible for them to go back to their hometown during the election time because it's too far from there. It's not possible for a one day holiday to go there.
No, I think they should make time. And especially when you have now the option of nota, none of the above, at least usme jaake do. Theek karna padega. Mujhe lagta hai compulsory hona chahiye.
Compulsory.
Well, everybody's opinion should be there. 50% voting result.
Yeah.
See, out of 50% of the electorate, somebody gets 20% of the 50% of the total vote, and he gets somebody gets 80%, and this is the elected representative. Think of it. I mean, your math is better than mine.
Yeah, the person voting percentage.
Is he really the elected representative?
The Congress got 25%.
I mean, by that logic, less than 1/4 people have actually voted for
him. Ma'am, so what policies do you think should be implemented to increase voter percentage?
I think some very good things have happened, like none of the above nota. So that's a good thing. But this doesn't mean anything. They should say that if their percentage of nota exceeds a certain amount, all the parties should have fresh, newer candidates because people have liked none of the above. Because now nota means nothing, it's just there. So there should be a number to it. I mean, let's say 20% of the votes, or let's say beyond 5,000, whatever the number is, they can calculate, take out the mean, median, mode of it all and figure out. And then they should say that now we don't want these elections are not viable. We need to have a fresh election. Because so many people have voted for nota, none of the other. So, there has to be that option. Parties have been forced to change their candidates.
Ma'am,
we do not have the DP others and all of the world.
Ma'am, as you yourself pointed out, you were previously in a journalistic career. So what exactly prompted you to take the plunge into politics?
I was an anchor with Star News and it was great fun. And I wore my jacket every day. I had makeup done and I said, Namaskar, I'm Shazia, Ilmi, and I'm great Star News. Patience for Kitaza Khabre. And it was a lot of power because Hindi news, you go all over. 7 years and I had my own show. But I felt, started feeling tired doing it. Money was great, everything was fine, but I wanted to do more. And usme bhi main ye bolti thi ki ab vote kijiye, vote dena zaruri hai. Lekin kisko vote dein? Because I knew the truth about all the parties. And I said, nothing will change. Again, it was about, I would see that it's satta parivartan and not vyavastha parivartan. So, I saw this opportunity with Anna. Somebody was rising up and saying, look, this is enough. Don't fool us anymore. We've had enough. And I just said, I'm going to be a part of this. So I even said, help me for 3 months. I was from media and all of them. And 3 months have become 3 years. And I don't think I'm going back. I don't think anybody will give me a job now.
can you give us your views on the Jadu campaign?
Oh, what a lovely campaign. Ours was the most unique campaign ever seen. They didn't know what to do. First they thought, you know kya jaate hai. But bus log up chale ki chalo and it's well with the jhaadus and it was just so
and in your campaign videos they have shown how you went from house to house with the jhaadu.
Yeah.
Really good.
आपका क्या मानना है सत्ता परिवर्तन के लिए क्या राजनीति में आना जरूरी है या तो आप जिस स्थान पे हैं उस पे रह के आप सत्ता में परिवर्तन ला सकते हैं
मेरे हिसाब से क्योंकि सारे बिल्स लॉस पॉलिटिक्स का असर हर चीज से बढ़ता है. क्या बजट है सैनिटेशन का, क्या बजट है डिफेंस का, क्या बजट है शिक्षा का, क्योंकि सारा असर उस पर होता है. सारे कानून वहाँ पास होते हैं और क्योंकि जो ये हमारे मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट हैं इनकी देखरेख पे सब काम होता है. लॉ एंड ऑर्डर मशीनरी भी रिपोर्ट करती है एक तरह से पॉलिटिकल मास्टर्स को. इसलिए अगर आप सच्चा बदलाव चाहते हैं, पुख्ता बदलाव चाहते हैं, तो यू टू पेनिट्रेट, यू हैव टू एंटर पॉलिटिक्स. आप आंदोलन कर सकते हैं, आप आंदोलन करते रहिए, आप भूखे रह के मर जाएंगे तो सुनेगा नहीं आपको.
आम आदमी तो सारे लोग अगर पॉलिटिक्स में आ जाएंगे तो फिर देश में मतलब बहुत सारे मतलब प्लेस ऐसा भी बचेगा जहाँ लोगों को अपना काम करना पड़ेगा. जैसे एज ए जर्नलिस्ट आपको मतलब अपना काम करना पड़ेगा, कोई
एनजीओ
हाँ अगर हमें
पर्सनल doctors, undercover, we are undercover activists. So it could be doctor but undercover activists. You know, like undercover whistleblower, all times. Nahi gaya pharmaceuticals mein.